what an academic community means to a group of people, you know, to galvanize them, to pool their resources, you know, to such an extent, you know, kind of gives you a sense of perspective all the way back to me, you know, in my prep school experience, you know, Winchington, you know, it was great. The athletics, you know, in these particular prep schools is outstanding. We just had the Hoops Hall Classic that was out in Springfield. That's pretty cool. Yeah, why am I talking so slow? You know why I'm talking slow. You know why we were talking about Hoops Hall Classic. Your boy LeBron James was in the building this year, folks. All right, and it was an outstanding thing. Young Bronny, okay, on his journey. Dad, LeBron, taking time. Beautiful thing. Okay, this Friday Night Lights. Okay, and this journey that the fathers and the sons, you know, and the wives and the daughters go through. This rite of passage, okay? Privilege that we have. Yes, sports is not everything. It's not all-encompassing. We need to remember that sometimes, okay? But how it ties people together, families together, communities together. It's a beautiful thing. Beautiful thing. Yes, you know, it doesn't do everything for people. And we're going to get to that. Okay, sports cannot save you. We're going to address that in this show. All right, and we need to be mindful of that balance. It's something that I always go back to myself. And we'll get to the topics, you know, but we this show is autobiographical, so I'm going to talk to you. I got to talk to you. And I thought this was, I'm talking to you. You know, one of the quotations and principles that is near and dear to me, you know, is from Coach K, you know, a man who I greatly admire and respect. You know, he says, you know, I don't look at myself as a basketball coach. So I look at myself as a leader who happens to coach basketball. And Coach K, coming from the military tradition, a graduate of West Point, where he played for a guy named Bobby Knight. Another thing that Coach K said that really resonates with me is, look, games are easy. Games are easy. It's the will to prepare that's hard. That's what makes a difference. You know, Marcellus Wiley, I mentioned it, the separation and the preparation. This show, and right now, this is beautiful. This is just, I'm in a flow, I'm in a groove. Wonderful. But this is the easy part. It's the preparation for the show, for the game, that makes a difference. It's the preparation for your job. Okay, for you know, your family, for yourself and the self-care, all right? And those quiet hours where it's just you having to do those same things over and over again, that's the hard part that makes the real difference. That's the foundation, okay? This here, this is the rooftop. This is the easy part, all right? All the way, you know, back to, you know, NFL and, you know, how to sport, you know, myself, you know, my little prep school, you know, story that I wanted to talk to you about when I was in prep school, you know, kind of all the way back. I remember we went one day and we went to Mount Monadnock, climbed to Mount Monadnock. Monadnock. I think it's New Hampshire. It might be right in the Massachusetts, New Hampshire border. Never forget this. 2001, some years ago now. My 20-year reunion is coming up this year. Never forget this. And I was doing cross country, hyperactive then, just like I'm hyperactive now. Let me just quick time check. Yeah, we're doing all right. And never forget it. Kicking things. I sprinted out ahead of everybody else because I wanted to get up this mountain. You know, walking, hiking. I had no problem. I couldn't walk with the people. I had to sprint. Sprint out ahead. And I ended up sprinting out ahead on my own. And I got lost. Go all the way back and come back and find the right route. And everybody else, that should have been a lesson in and of itself. Come to find out, as I'm walking up and climbing up the mountain and getting to like where you're really high up, on this mountain. And once, you know, you get out from the trees and you see how high in the air you are. I'm scared of heights, you know, and I was frightened. We got up there and we were like, man, you know, I was like, oh man, I could fall, and I got anxious and all the rest of this stuff. and I was with the group, and we had to kind of maneuver, and you know, we felt like, I mean, in, it's not as high as you think, you know, but you kind of get up there and you feel one way or another. Case in point, the group charged forward and made it to the summit. And I said to myself, you know, I said, there'll be other days. There'll be other days. I'll come back and I'll do this, you know, and I'll take care of it then. That's 2001, close to 20 years ago. I have never been anywhere near close to Mount Monadnock in the successive years. You know, in the years since. All right? In all likelihood, I will never climb Mount Monadnock. But at the time, remember, like it was yesterday, I said, there'll be other days. I'll come back to this. Get to that summit. Achieve that goal. And move on. It's 19 years ago.